Really? You think you can fight a guy?
Yeah.
You really think you can fight a guy?
Yeah. Yeah. She's like, yes.
Fight you.
Yes. Yes. Let me fight you.
Yes. You guys.
I was sparring with
my ex was 6'5" yes. And
that doesn't matter
up.
Though. I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna disagree with you guys. I would never put my hands
like,
on a man
what?
Because I don't want my man putting his hands on me.
Exactly.
I don't think I could even square up to a man. Even though I know I can fight real good or whatever you want to say, I would never.
Okay. So okay. Here's the thing. Here's the thing. You guys, we live in such times of peace that you guys don't even know the chaos that a 15-year-old boy can do to you. I'll tell you guys this right now. You two, what, three of you said you could fight a man? A 14-year-old boy will fuck each of you up. I promise you. A 14-year-old boy.
Never.
Men have 10 times as much testosterone as you. We have stronger bone density. We have higher VO2 max. We have higher lung capacity. We have more blood. We can literally destroy a woman.
The fight for equality has literally made women insane. Men are physically superior to women. Most men can beat most women. If you take a man at 130 pounds and a woman at 130 pounds, that man is going to decimate that woman. They're simply bigger, stronger, and faster. Now, there are the few outliers. There may be a woman that can beat a particularly weak man, so on and so forth. But in general, a man will physically decimate a woman. All right, so this video comes from Bunny Mun's TikTok channel. I'll leave a link to her channel down in the description. Be sure to check her out. She does a lot of comparative men versus women videos. And this happens to be a track and field event, a mixed track and field event, where every team has a man running anchor except one.
One girl against a whole male team at the end, and she went straight from the first place to the last place. Oh my god, why?
It's crazy because she started off with such a massive lead. Each team consists of three guys, one female, and for her team, all of the males ran ahead of her, whereas the other teams kind of staggered them in the first, second, or third position. So she had a gigantic lead, and you saw what happened. She got hawked almost immediately. The guy caught her within seconds of her running out of there. I mean, men are just physically stronger than women. It's insane. All right, so for this next clip, this is some Asian kind of game show. I'm not sure. I couldn't find the name of it. But essentially what they have to do, it's men versus women, but they have to compete to see who has possession of the ball before the 3 minutes runs out. And if you look, the lady is just stacked. Goddamn, she is built like a brick house. And the guy is extremely slight, unassuming, but we'll just roll a clip.
The one-on-one death match is about to start.
In his pockets. That's crazy.
Oh, he looks chill. He's so chill. How cool is that? Oh, too near.
I mean, she starts off cocky. Just throws the ball out there like she was tough. You know, it had a little shit talk to it. Okay.
He's out on a stroll. What's he doing with his hands in his pockets? Looks like a fair match, doesn't it?
Yes. She has a great body and she's a freaking strong woman.
Looking good.
Looking good. No, throw it. Nice.
He's strong, though.
He's using his technique already.
Oh, she can't flip him over. He won't go over. Whoa!
tried to take out those legs, he hit her with the straight judo throw, like Steven Seagal.
He's upset. What is this?
Sitting on me, and I couldn't break free. It wasn't even that heavy, but I couldn't get up.
Release! It's not fun! It's not fun!
I kind of hate that. Like, because he's winning, and it the match would clearly have been over for the next 2 minutes. They go ahead and reset and stand everybody up. I wonder what would happen if she was winning.
What's with that guy? His gaze felt threatening. Gave me chills. It's like freeing your prey.
She called it threatening. He did the zip your mouth gesture. He didn't slit the throat, you know, thumb to the throat. Said, zip your mouth. Shut up.
It's even scarier.
What you need?
Whoa.
That's a fighting skill.
Whoa, look at that technique.
Sorry. Time for the solar plexus.
The chest! Chest!
He's really merciless.
He shows zero mercy.
Everyone in this environment wants to survive and wants to win. And I came here to win. Sorry to do this.
There's nothing she can do. Yes, she can't beat an expert when they do that.
I mean, even during the clinch, you can see she was clearly outmatched. They clinched. He suplexed her to the ground. And then, because he's in total control, and for however long they have on the clock, he would just be sitting there on the chest. So they reset it again.
Yes, to the end. The last 15 seconds. Run. You must run. Run, just run. To the end. Get him.
And Arena B is over.
Nice one, Cherie.
Well done. You put up a good fight.
Nice one, Cherie. You were awesome.
Yeah, I'll give her that. That was definitely a great takedown. But there was simply nothing she can do. Even I wasn't sure how much she weighed versus him, but even as big as she was, as many weights as she lifted, she couldn't do anything against just an average size guy.
The men's game is embarrassingly cynical. The crybabies dive and pretend to be injured. Women's football is way more hardcore.
The Australian women's national team, who were ranked number 5 in the world, lost 7-0 to a team of 15-year-old boys.
Awkward. Women are better skilled.
Well, the women are better skilled against other women. But if the women played the men, they wouldn't be winning the way that they went.
He's in a tight corner here. What's he going to do? Oh, that's what he's going to do. That was incredible.
Men always say how women's soccer sucks. Then come to the field and try it with us.
Yeah, they're looking like Messi, bro.
Women will never beat men at football. Physiologically, they won't be able to. Maybe I'm wrong. It's not a sexist comment to say that.
No, and I accept that on strength and power and physicality, I accept that you're right. My point is that whether on skill, they could beat.
And, not sure if he was going to get on the end of that, Neymar Jr. Little flick there. Nearly. Oh, it's gone in.
What a move.
Guarda, que ahí se escapa el número 7. Se escapa el número 7 si la hace bien. Sí, 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 puede ser, le pegó.
He's going to try and go on his own all the way. Oh, he has!
I'm going to be challenging one of the best women's goalkeepers in the country. She plays for Manchester City and England.
Oh.
don't think anybody can argue that there's gender inequities in this world, that there's a pay gap, that there's pay discrepancy.
Matilda's Soccer World Cup win against Brazil. Now, if they make it to the final, the girls will get $5,500 each. The blokes will get $69,000 each. How can anyone justify this, Aita?
They can't.
No.
I mean, the gender... I beg your pardon?
I can justify
how?
It. How many of you guys on the panel know who our Australian Matildas are playing in the quarterfinals?
Don't.
No, because you don't care about it. Now, if you cared about
it... I do if they win.
No, but that's the thing.
They beat Brazil.
Do you know what? All of you can go and watch W League games in the women's competition here, but you don't. Mm. Now, when you start to go and watch these women play the wonderful football they do, then they'll earn more money.
We've got quite a large pay dispute happening with our Australian women's soccer team at the moment. Is it frustrating for you as someone who's so prominent in your sport... And we heard you say on the Ellen show the other day you are the richest fighter in UFC, that that sort of thing is still going on?
I think that how much you get paid should have something to do with how much money you bring in. I'm the highest paid fighter not because Dana and Lorenzo wanted to do something nice for the ladies. They do it because I bring in the highest numbers. They do it because I make them the most money. And I think that the money that they make should be proportionate to the money that they bring in.
When your paycheck is dependent on people coming and wanting to buy your service, where they're forced to get it, but they want to buy your service, then it depends on the audience.
The U.S. women's soccer team is taking charge in a major fight off the field, suing for fair pay.
28 members of the U.S. women's national soccer team filing a gender discrimination lawsuit against the U.S. Soccer Federation.
We know in our hearts, and we know with the facts that we have, that we're on the right side of this.
The case was dismissed, and now the men who earned the majority, 97% of the revenue, they have to now split it equally with the women's team, who only are earning 2.5% of what the men are making. And this, they want you to believe, is equal pay.
If the women generate more revenue, they should get paid more than the men. Don't strive for getting the same. Strive for getting what you're worth. And if you're worth more, then get more.
The men's team makes more money. Hey. If they make more money, then they should get more money.
Why is the men's team...
The men's team makes more money because because people are more interested in
it. Why are people more interested in the men's sports? Because it's been
historically... it's more interesting to watch.
I don't think anybody can argue that there's gender inequities in this world, that there's a pay gap, that there's pay discrepancies.
Women's soccer in America and in other Western countries like Australia, we see there's a lot of support in these countries.
Where soccer's biggest, like in South America and in Africa, like people aren't really paying attention to women's soccer at all. It's going to take like huge cultural shifts in all those countries before we even get to that.